Wow, viewers all over the world, thank you for your prayers and your support. I've been here for some time now. Permit me to sit. It has not been easy. Wow. Yes, viewers all over the world, this is another Sunday morning. It looks as if it wants to rain. So I have to be very snappy. But I quickly run back to my hiding place before the rain starts. I thank God for the strength. Thank you for your prayers and your support. Yes, this morning, you know, it is very important for us to realize the fact that God Almighty is waiting for us to love Him, to serve Him with all we have. As a matter of fact, that is what we are born for, living for, and are going to die for. These were the great sacrifice the apostles of old made to bring the gospel to our reach. The apostles of old, Apostle Peter, Apostle Paul, a host of other disciples, Matthew, James, John, Bartholomew, and the rest of them, you can imagine the kind of death they died. Imagine what they went through to bring this gospel we are enjoying today. So therefore, we should be ready and be available for God to use us. So that will take us to a brief message titled, You Can Be Used If You Are Willing. So at your privacy, you can take up the book of Luke chapter 5 verse 12 and also the book of Mark chapter 1 verses 16-18. So I'm going to take Mark chapter 1 because of time. Mark chapter 1 verses 16-18. Yes, it says, the caption says, Jesus calls his first disciples. Remember, we are talking about you can be used if you are willing. Jesus is not looking for the smart people to use. He's not looking for the intelligent people to use. He's not looking for the able-bodied to be used, educated, eloquent people, well-read people. People have the ability to inspire people. No, he's looking for those who are available. If you are available, you can be used for the glory of God. So let me take you to that book of Mark chapter 1, verses 16-18. It's all about Jesus' encounter with Peter, the great apostle. As Jesus walked beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother, Andrew, casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. Come, follow me, Jesus said, and I will send you out to fish for people. Wow. I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. If you follow me, says Jesus, if you follow me, I will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. I'm sorry, I'm not a good singer, but I will try my best. Yes. Come, follow me, Jesus said, and I will send you out to fish for people. At once, they left their nets and followed him. That is genuine willingness from the heart. Come, follow me. How many times has Jesus been calling you? How much effort have you made to follow him? Right from the time of conception in the womb of your mom, Jesus prepared you before putting you into the womb. And while you were born, he nurtured you, guiding you, protecting you by assigning guardian angels to protect you. When you became adult, now you see Jesus as no longer useful. You see Jesus as somebody you can kick around. You see Jesus as somebody you can ignore. Wow. You may ignore him, chastise him, embarrass him, but his love for you remains constant and unchanging. That is Jesus. Now, let us consider the case of Peter here. You agree with me that Jesus Christ of Nazareth found Peter in a state of confusion, discouragement, and dejection. And as a matter of Peter's soul, he offered Peter the opportunity, the awesome opportunity, to be transformed. I mean, for total and complete transformation. I mean, to take Peter from where he was to where Jesus wanted him to be. Peter instantly accepted the offer. And Peter's position, Peter's action and position was changed from catching fish to catching men. Jesus can change your situation today. From disappointment to appointment, from trouble to solution, from darkness to shining light, from setback, career failure to breakthrough and prosperity, from unsaved to saved, if you are willing. Transforming you is a matter of genuine willingness from your own side. It is not all up to Jesus, of course, and certainly it is not up to you. It takes your willingness and God's ability to make you what He wants you to be. If you are willing, Jesus Christ is ready, ever ready, to bring the balance. What is the balance? Take you out of trouble to solution. Take you out of sickness to good health. Take you out of bondage to freedom, deliverance, prosperity, breakthrough you're looking for. To enjoy a better life, to be part and parcel of a better life, life that is full of promises of God, faith is essential. Why? Because it is the transformative power of the universe. Power to change from unsaved to saved. Power to change from sickness to good health. Power to change from trouble to solution. Power to change from bondage to freedom. Power to change, to change, to change. From who you are to who He wants you to be. Many of us today are chasing shadow instead of substance. Running helter-skelter, looking for solution where there's no solution. Little trouble, you get provoked and start looking for solution alternatives outside the church, outside the body of Christ. And you expect things to work out good for you. Of what benefit? Of what good is it to leave Jesus and begin to look for solution from spiritualists, from witch doctors? The question you need to ask yourself before visiting a witch doctor, before visiting a spiritualist, the question is, what is the source of their power? Before you dress up in the morning and say, wow, I want to visit this spiritualist, I want to visit this herbalist, I want to visit this palm reader, I want to visit this fortune teller. Wow. The question you need to ask yourself is, what is the source of their energy, their power, their strength? Is it Jesus? Aha. You know the source. Then why do you go there? And of what solution do you expect to come from there? When Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that are labored and heavy laden, I will give you rest. And rest means freedom from sicknesses and diseases, from all fundamental issues of life, troubles on a daily basis. It means we know the right thing, but we refuse to do it. And we hope and believe it will not be too late to come back to Jesus Christ. You say you want Jesus. You say Jesus is your Lord and Savior, the Redeemer of your soul. When you enter the church, you raise your hand so high, you start praising God. And when people look at you praising God, singing wonderful songs, they will believe that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is just a second away from you, whereas your heart is full of unforgiveness. Your heart is full of immoralities. Your heart is full of deep, deep hatred towards your fellow human beings. And you're expecting to get it right. And you're expecting to prosper in that regard. It is impossible. Because the owner of prosperity can never release prosperity to you, because he knows that when he prospers you, he uses it to destroy people. One thing we don't understand is this. God Almighty is in our future. You are the owner of this moment. Fine. But the next moment, you can't tell. The next second, you can't tell. The next, you can't predict. That is where God is waiting for you. Many of us will say, I've been praying for breakthrough. I've been praying to buy a car. I've been praying to build a house. Whereas the willingness to serve Jesus is not there. Each time you pray for something, before God Almighty will give you that thing, he will look at your 2 years' time. He will look at your 3 years' time. He will look at your 4 years' time. If I bless this gentleman, this gentle lady, with this blessing, of what use, of what benefit will this blessing be to him or her? He will look at your future, 2 years' time, 3 years' time, 4 years' time, 5 years' time, and so on and so forth. If Jesus Christ realizes that, that blessing will be used to hurt people, he will not give it to you. If Jesus realizes that, that blessing will be used against his will and purpose for your life, he will not give it to you. He will wait until you have a change of heart. When you have a change of heart, he will bless you more than ever before. That is why sometimes people will say, I just bought a car. Hey, 2 years ago, I prayed for this car. Yes, you got it today because this is when you are ready to use it to serve God. What a mighty God we serve. Suddenly you realize that you've been looking for contracts for 5 years. It couldn't come. But the fifth year, it came. And immediately it dawned on you that, 5 years ago, I prayed for contract. It just came today. Yes. Jesus released that contract to you today because he realized that now you are prepared to serve him, to love your neighbor, to help your neighbor with that contract. That's why he released it. So if you are praying for something and there's a delay, ask yourself, are you willing to be used by Jesus to get that thing for the glory of Jesus tomorrow? Are you willing to help your neighbor, those who are poor, those who are wretched, the physically challenged, the orphans, the destitute, the elderly? Are you ready to share with them? If you are not ready, Jesus is not ready to give it to you until you are ready. Two, some of you will pray for something, it's not forthcoming. You are a good follower of Jesus, fine. But you pray for something, it's not forthcoming. Don't get angry. Don't be disturbed. Don't be worried. Why? Because Jesus will look at your future and he wants to make sure that that blessing will bring glory to him. Of what benefit will you buy a car and have an accident with it and die? Of what benefit will you build a house and the house will collapse and kill you? Of what benefit will you receive a contract and tomorrow you are in the jail? Who will execute the contract? Of what benefit will it be to you for you to marry and tomorrow you divorce? So all those things you are looking for, if you are the apple of God's eye, God will hold on. Go to your future, clear every obstacle in your way. It may take God 2 months. It may take God 1 year, depending on how willingly you are. 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. After the obstacle is cleared, those blessings just come. Pip! Say, hey, 5 years ago I prayed for this. Yes. To delay is not to deny. Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the lover of your soul, is working out the answer slowly but surely. Give him time. The results are working themselves slowly but surely. In due time, they will issue out in glory. Hallelujah, somebody. So my brother, my sister, my mother, my father, make yourself available to be used by God. And God is ready to supply your needs according to his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. And I pray, having listened to this message, you will make yourself available to be used by God. Wow. Father Lord Jesus, we thank you. We bless your holy name. And I commit all who are under the influence of this program. Father, every obstacle that would deny them the usefulness for your glory, I cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every hindrance to their soul being available, to their heart being available for you to be used, with the staff of Moses, I divide and scatter in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every demon, every evil spirit, gathering around their progress, gathering around their family, disturbing them from serving you. Hey, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I divide and scatter the association of demons around your family right now, right now. Be divided, association of demons. Be divided, association of evil spirits. Hey, take the key. I open your door. Hey, rush out. Go, 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 you demon. Go, you demon. You evil spirit, go out of the house. Come on, go. Enter no more. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy, for your favor. To viewers all over the world, thank you for your prayers and your support. I'm sitting in a quiet place praying for you. I know you are praying for me. Please pray for me. Pray for me. I need your prayer. Send in your testimonies, your praise reports, your prayer requests. And hopefully pretty soon I'll be going back home because I know our prayers are answered. Thank you. God bless you. Yes, because it looks as if it wants to rain early Sunday morning. The whole place is cloudy. Wow, let me quickly rush down to my private place. Wow. I'm going to my quiet place. Thank you. See.